Hi all, today we learn cluster analysis. Cluster analysis or clustering is an unsupervised machine learning task. So here we are given a set of data points without any class labels. So we have to find some hidden structure from these data points. That is, we have to group data into meaningful clusters or groups. So partitioning a set of data objects into subsets or groups is called clustering. And each subcluster is in such a way that the objects belonging to a cluster will be similar to each other and those belonging to different clusters will be dissimilar. So unlike classification, we don't have any class labels here. That is why it is called unsupervised machine learning. In classification, we are given a set of data points along with their class labels. So when an unknown object comes, we have to predict the class of that object. That is what classification does, and it is supervised machine learning task. Unlike classification, clustering, we don't have any class labels. That is why it is unsupervised. So here, if we consider, we have a two-dimensional set of points. You can see that this could be the natural grouping of points. So finding such grouping of points from a set of unlabeled data, that is called clustering. The applications of clustering are, in business intelligence, we can use clustering for segmenting customers, that is grouping customers who have similar behavior. So this is useful for business to promote, to make promotions or recommendations for a particular group of customers. And another application is, you can group similar projects into categories. So this can help to improve project management. These are the applications in business intelligence. And then it is also useful in image pattern recognition, that is in image segmentation. For example, in medical images, you can cluster out lesions or cancerous images using clustering techniques. Another is, you can another application in image processing is, you can develop handwritten character recognition systems. So different people write characters in different ways. So identifying these characters or recognizing these characters, you can use clustering techniques. In web search, we can use clustering to organize results into groups. When you give a search query, you'll get a set of results. So organizing these results based on relevance is another application of clustering. And you can also cluster documents into topics, similar documents, and have topic modeling using clustering. In biology, it is useful in classifying plant and animal kingdom given their features. That is, the animal kingdom can be divided into phylum, species, and so on. So identifying this hierarchical structure makes use of clustering. Also, we can group genes that have similar functions, that perform similar functions, can be grouped into clusters using clustering techniques. And another application is outlier detection. Outlier are nothing but points that doesn't belong to any of the groups. So they are considered as noise. So this can be detected, and unusual behavior can be detected as outlier or noise and can be removed out using clustering. So an example of this is credit card fraud detection. If a credit card has been stolen, the unusual transaction pattern will reveal that it is having an abnormal behavior and can be detected. So these are the popular applications of clustering techniques. Now when we represent data in clustering, data representation can be of two types: data matrix or object by variable structure, and dissimilarity matrix or object by object structure. First is the data matrix, that is variable object by variable structure. Here an object can be represented as a n-dimensional vector. So x1, x2 up to x1p, this is one object. So an x11, x12, etc. are the features of that object. So this is, so these values corresponds to the feature values. So this is the data matrix corresponding to a data set. Here we have n objects and p features. So each data will be represented using a n-dimensional or p-dimensional feature vector. This is called data matrix representation. When we come to dissimilarity matrix, Here we will be representing the dissimilarity between or the distance between objects. Here distance, so this is an n-dimensional matrix. Here we will be representing the difference or distance between objects. So D21 represents the difference between object 2 and 1. D31 is the difference between object 3 and object 1 and so on. So the diagonal entries will be 0 because distance between that object and itself is 0. We'll have entries below the diagonal that will be representing the dissimilarity between points. So this is another representation for use for clustering. Now clustering basically uses distance measures to find similarity or dissimilarity between points and groups the data points into clusters or meaningful groups. For this we make use of similarity measures, and the distance measures used are Euclidean distance, Manhattan distance and Chebyshev distance. So Euclidean distance between two points x and y is square root of sigma xi minus yi the whole square. That is, we will be taking the difference between each dimension and square them and sum them and take the square root. That is what Euclidean distance gives. So if there are two dimensional points x1 y1 and x2 y2, this will be square root of x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. And Manhattan distance is just the absolute difference between each dimension. So xi minus yi, that is if you have two dimensional points x1 y1 and x2 y2, it will be x1 minus x2 plus y1 minus y2. And Chebyshev distance will be the maximum of absolute value of distance among the dimensions, across the dimensions. So whichever dimension gives maximum distance, that will be the distance between two points. So these points can be n dimensional, so we will be summing up across the dimensions to find the distance measures. So these are the popular distance measures used in clustering. Now we have different categories of clustering techniques. The main categories are partitioning methods, hierarchical methods, density based methods and grid based methods. We will see each of them briefly and some examples for each. First one is partitioning methods. So as the name indicates, it divides a set of points into k groups and it is based on distance between the data points. So it uses an iterative approach. In each iteration, distance between points belonging to a group will be calculated and points will be moving from one object, from one cluster to another until this gets stabilized. So this is what convergence means. Points will be initially grouped into some group. They will be moving from one group to another until the clusters are finalized. So this is called partitioning method. And the popular algorithms in partitioning methods are k-means and k-Meadowitz algorithm. So this is how partitioning algorithm divides data set. Here we have three set of data points. This will be partitioned into three clusters based on the features. Next is hierarchical method. This creates a hierarchical decomposition of the data points. That is, we will have a hierarchy where top level hierarchy will be composed of bottom level hierarchy and so on. So this is of two types, agglomerative, which is a bottom up approach, and divisive, which is a top down approach. Now let's see what it is. So agglomerative means each object will be considered as a separate cluster and they will be grouped into hierarchy as we move up. So A and B forms a cluster here, then A, B and C forms a cluster here and so on. So we will be moving or making building clusters bottom to top fashion. That is called agglomerative clustering. And in divisive clustering, we will have all set of points at the top level and we will be breaking down into subclusters until each points are in different clusters. So at different level of abstraction, we will have set of clusters. So if we need clustering at this level, we can extract that cluster. So this will represent some hierarchical structure of points in a given set of data points. So classification of plant kingdom or animal kingdom into phylum, again into species and so on, is an example of hierarchical clustering. So divisive is a top-down approach and agglomerative is a bottom-up approach. And some of the algorithms in hierarchical methods are Birch, Diana and Agnes. In density-based methods, we will be dividing data set into low density and high density region. So for any point, there should a radius will be considered, and within that radius there should be a minimum set of points, then only that will be considered as a density or dense region, and based on the density objects will be grouped into clusters. And the specialty of this density based method is that we can filter out noise or outliers. So noise is some pattern, or outliers are some objects that are entirely different from any group of clusters. So they don't fall into any cluster and they have to be separated out. They will be noises or outliers. So this algorithm is used to filter out noise or outliers, and it can also detect clusters of arbitrary shape. When we take partitioning algorithm, it generates a spherical shapes clusters only. Or if we see hierarchical, we'll have a hierarchical structure, breaking down of objects into different clusters at different levels. But here, this algorithm lets you identify clusters of different shapes. Any arbitrary shape clusters can be detected using density based algorithms. And the examples for density based algorithms are DBSCAN and OPTICS. So this is how clusters in a density based clustering look like. After the execution of the algorithm, you can detect this type of clusters, that is, these are not of any particular shape. So we can detect arbitrary shape clusters using density based algorithms. So these are density connected regions. So these are dense regions that are identified as clusters, or these are also dense regions having large number of data points that will be separated using density based clustering. So outliers can also be detected using density based, that is what it makes different from partitional and hierarchical clustering. The last category of methods is grid based methods. Here we'll be clustering the points based on a grid structure. So grid is nothing but a object space having the number of finite number of cells, and the clustering operations are performed on this grid structure. And the peculiarity is that it is fast than other clustering techniques, and it depends on the grid structure and not on the number of data objects. So some of the algorithms are Sting and Click. This is how a grid based algorithm works. We'll have a grid like structure, and we'll be using a density or any other criteria for grouping points in the grid space. So I have talked about only a few algorithms in each category. There are hundreds of algorithms in each category, and in next video we'll see partitioning algorithm. And here you have the summary of the clustering techniques. The partitioning methods, it is k-means and k-medoids are the example of partitioning methods. They are used to find spherical shaped clusters, and it is based on distance. So mean or median will be used, that we will see later. And it is effective for small to medium data set. In hierarchical, we will have a hierarchical decomposition at multiple levels. And in density based, we can have arbitrary shaped clusters, or we can separate out outliers or noise. In grid based, it uses a grid structure, and objects will be mapped into the grid structure for clustering. And the specialty is that it is faster compared to other clustering techniques, and it is dependent on the grid size rather than the number of data objects. So this is all about the main categories of clustering. We'll see example of each of these clustering in the coming lectures. Thank you.